Binance NFT Marketplace is a centralized NFT marketplace hosted on the world's biggest crypto ecosystem. The marketplace brings together artists, creators, and crypto enthusiasts on a single platform to create, buy, and sell top NFTs with the best liquidity and minimal fees. In this video, I'm going to tell you everything you need to know about the Binance NFT marketplace and show you step by step how you can get started on the platform and begin buying and selling top NFTs today. For starters, why should you collect and trade NFTs on the Binance NFT marketplace? AKA, what are the benefits of the Binance platform compared to the other platforms out there? For me, one of the biggest benefits are the low fees. If you are just starting out in the world of NFTs, it makes no sense to be paying very high fees for your transactions before you even fully understand the ins and outs of trading NFTs. Binance charges just 1% platform fee with the highest liquidity, which is just awesome. Another huge benefit is variety. On the Binance platform, you have the marketplace feature where you can find unique NFTs from everyday creators from around the world. You have premium events where you can find exclusive NFTs from global influential artists and brands. And you also have mystery boxes where you can get a mixture of NFTs with different rarity levels. So if you are the type that loves surprises, this will be perfect for you. Another big benefit is exclusivity. Binance NFT is the first and only NFT marketplace to launch the mystery box feature, which I just talked about. Another big benefit for those of us who don't like creating too many accounts is that the marketplace is accessible with your regular Binance account, meaning if you already have a Binance account, you can use it to access the NFT marketplace. You don't need to create a new account, and that is very convenient. Now that you know the benefits, what kinds of NFTs can you collect and trade on the Binance NFT marketplace? There are three different types of NFTs that you can collect and trade on the Binance NFT platform. You have the marketplace NFTs, which are unique NFTs that are created by regular everyday creators from around the world. You see these NFTs when you log into the NFT platform and you click on Marketplace. You also have the premium NFTs, which are exclusive NFTs from global influential brands and celebrities. The third type of NFTs are the mystery boxes, which contain NFTs of different rarity levels with an element of gamification and surprise. You see these NFTs when you log into the NFT platform and click on mystery boxes at the top here. So how can you get started on the platform if you want to buy or sell NFTs? If you already have a Binance account, all you need to do is visit the Binance NFT Marketplace webpage. The link is in the description box of this video, so you can just click it and go there. When the page opens, click on Login and enter the email address and password of your regular Binance account. Click on Login, move the slider to align this puzzle piece here, enter your authentication code, and you will be logged into the platform. From here, you can begin to trade directly. If you don't have a Binance account yet, you can click on my referral link in the description box below to create your account. When the page opens, you can choose to register with either your email address or your mobile phone number. If you prefer to use your email, enter the email in this box here. Enter the password that you want to use. Click here to read the terms of service, and if you agree with it, click this box here that says I have read and agreed to Binance terms of service, and then click on create account. If you prefer to register with your mobile phone, You just need to click on mobile at the top here. Click this arrow and scroll down the list to select your country. Then enter your phone number here. Enter the password you want to use. Tick the box to accept the terms of service and click on create account. Once your account has been created, you need to log into your account and make sure you complete your ID verification process. Once you have your Binance account and you can access the NFT platform, you are going to need some money in your Binance account to buy the NFTs with. You need that money in either BNB, BUSD, or Ethereum, because those are the coins that you can use to buy NFTs on the Binance NFT marketplace. You can deposit any of these coins into your Binance account, meaning that if you have BNB, BUSD, or Ethereum in another exchange or wallet, you can transfer it into your Binance account, or you can just buy the coins directly on the Binance Trade platform. What you need to keep in mind is that if you want to buy NFTs with BUSD, then you need to have some BUSD in your Binance account. If you want to buy NFTs with BNB or Ethereum, then you need to have BNB or Ethereum in your Binance account. Now that you know how to get started on the platform, let me show you how to buy NFTs. Right now, I have some BUSD, which I'm going to use to purchase the NFT. Since I'm already logged in, I will click on NFT at the top of the page. It will pop up the NFT marketplace terms and conditions. Scroll down to read it, and if you are okay with it, click on accept. This will open up the NFT marketplace homepage where you will see the trending NFTs. To browse for other NFTs on the market, scroll to the top of the page here and click on marketplace. Then scroll down to see the available NFTs. Each NFT listed for sale will have the name of the NFT, the current bid or the price, and the name of the creator. If you see price here, it means that NFT is being sold for a fixed price. For example, this Cam 2D jersey is being sold for 50 BUSD. If you see current bid here, it means that NFT is on auction and it will be sold to the highest bidder when the auction ends. To buy a fixed price NFT, scroll through the marketplace until you see one that you like. Or you can use the search bar to search for any type of NFT you're looking for. Or alternatively, you can use the filters at the top of the listing to streamline what gets displayed to you. For example, I can say show me only NFTs that I can buy with BUSD and that the price is between $1 and $17. Once you find an NFT that you want to buy, click on it to open the details page. You will see the details of the NFT like the name, the description, the price, how long before the listing expires, and so on. You can scroll down to see more information about the NFT, like who minted it, and the people who have purchased it before you. If you are okay with the details that you see, click on Buy Now. Review the details and click on Confirm. You will see a message telling you that your purchase was successful. When you buy an NFT, it goes into your collection and you can see it by clicking on Collections here and selecting the right tab. To buy an NFT by bidding, which is an NFT that is on auction, you also need to find one that you like and click on it. You can scroll down the page to see the bidding history, that is the people who have placed their bids for that item before you. Click on Place a Bid. You will see the price the highest bidder is offering for the NFT. The minimum markup is the least amount of money that you have to add to the current bid price in order to place your bid. For example, the current bid price of this item is $7.65. However, the minimum markup is 0.05 BUSD, meaning that I must add at least 0.05 BUSD to the current bid price of $7.65 if I want to bid for this item. That will be $7.70. You can enter a higher price for an item, but you can't enter anything less than the minimum markup plus the current bid. In this case, I can't enter anything less than 7.7, but I can enter a higher price like $10. Next, click on Place Bid. You will see a message telling you that your bid was successful, and you can click on Bidding Orders to see the status of your bid. Right now, I'm the highest bidder for this item, and I have about 2 hours and 11 minutes before this auction ends. If nobody places a higher bid at the end of the auction time, the NFT will be added to my collection. But if other people place higher bids, then the highest bidder will take the NFT at the end of the auction. To buy an NFT mystery box, scroll to the top of the NFT marketplace page and click on mystery boxes. Then scroll down the page to see what is available as well as the prizes. Click on the mystery box you are interested in buying. You will see the amount of time left before the listing expires here. If you scroll down the page, you will see the possible NFTs that could be in the mystery box, the number of each item, the rarity rank. For example, these ones are all super rare. And on the right-hand side, you will see the percentage possibility of actually having that item in the mystery box. To buy the mystery box, click on Buy Now here. If you don't have enough money in your wallet, you will be prompted to buy more crypto or deposit more crypto into your account, and the button to confirm your purchase will be grayed out. Once you have enough money in your account, the button will become clickable again, and you can click on Confirm for the mystery box to be added to your collection. Once you have bought a mystery box, you can choose to open it and sell the individual items inside, or you can leave the box closed and sell it just the way you bought it. Selling your NFT is very simple. Just click on User Center from the top of the NFT marketplace page and locate the NFT that you want to sell in your collection. Click on List NFT on the one that you want to sell. Under Sell Method, select Set Price if you want to sell your NFT for a fixed amount of money. You can set the amount of the item you want to sell here, but because I have only one of this item, I can't change this number. I have to go with one. You can choose which cryptocurrency you want to be paid in by clicking this arrow here and selecting the one of your choice. Enter the price that you want to sell your NFT for, and the fee for that transaction will be displayed here. You can change the expiration date and time of your listing, but whatever you choose can't be less than 12 hours or more than 7 days. Once you have entered all the required details, click on Submit. If you want to sell your NFT on auction, select Highest Bid from the top here. Click this arrow to select the coin that you want to receive your payment in, and enter the minimum amount potential buyers are allowed to bid. If I enter $150 here, for example, it means that bidding will start at $150 and people are only allowed to bid higher than $150. Select the minimum markup you want here. The minimum markup is the minimum amount of money people can add to the current bid price to place their own bids. Set the expiration date for the listing here and click on Submit. Review the details and click on Confirm to submit your NFT for review. Binance will manually review your listing, and that process takes anywhere from 4 to 8 hours. Once your NFT is approved for sale, it will become available for purchase on the NFT marketplace. The last thing I'm going to talk about is creating your own NFT. In the NFT world, making or creating an NFT is called minting your own NFT. And right now, the feature that allows you to create your own NFT on the Binance NFT marketplace is only available on an invite-only basis. But Binance has announced that in the future, this feature will be available to all users. That is the Binance NFT marketplace in a nutshell. If you would like to get started with collecting and trading NFTs, click on the link in the description box below to visit the Binance NFT marketplace today. Thank you for watching and God bless your hustle.